The iPhone 5 was the last iPhone Steve Jobs ever collaborated on, and the last iPhone with the classic UI of old iOS. It's had a good run, but unfortunately, all good things must come to an end. Hey, how's it going? I'm Josh from 91Tech, and today we're going to be taking a look at the life and death of the iPhone 5. So you might be confused. Didn't the iPhone 5 die over a year ago when iOS 11 came out and it was stuck on 10? Well, yeah, it kinda did, that's fair, but now it's officially dead, as Apple put it under the category of vintage and obsolete on their website. This means they will no longer do any repairs for you if you need one, and while that shouldn't be a big deal to most people, it is kinda sad that the iPhone that had iOS 6 originally is officially dead. While you do still have support for many apps on it with iOS 10, it won't be long before that changes and the iPhone 5 will become unusable. I hate that, but it's just kind of the way technology works. Tech moves at a much faster pace than any other industry, and so while iconic devices like the iPhone 5 might be considered obsolete, at least we can still appreciate them all these years later for the impact and importance they had on the market. And so today we're just going to talk a little bit about it because I thought this was kind of interesting. The iPhone 5 was released about a year after Steve Jobs' passing in late 2012 and again shipped with the iconic iOS 6. It was a seamless experience, and I'd say one of the fastest iPhones we've ever seen at launch. I'd say the iPhone 5 on its original software compares pretty well to the iPhone XS, at least when it comes to basic tasks. Obviously, games and real apps will slow it down, but for things like texting, calling, music, and so on, the performance is surprisingly comparable. And what was especially impressive about the iPhone 5, to the point that I've said it's what an iPhone should be, is how well it held up over the years. It got 5 years of support and never actually felt slow, unlike its predecessor, the mess that was the iPhone 4S. iOS 9 on the 4S isn't exactly a pleasant experience. The 5 was better mostly thanks to the full gigabyte of RAM. This sounds pretty low considering we have 4 gigs in the newest iPhone, but in 2012 this was pretty crazy and made the iPhone 5 a beast compared to anything else Apple had ever done with iPhones. The iPhone 5 was also extremely well designed, made to be used with one hand while still being larger than the iPhone 4. It is very comfortable to hold and the design is so well loved that Apple even brought it back in 2016 with the iPhone SE, a phone that was being sold new all the way up to the release of the XS. While not everybody likes the small size of the SE, there is a lot of people who do, and the iPhone 5 did it extremely well, while even being one of the lightest smartphones ever and having an absolutely beautiful design. The glass on the top and bottom of the aluminum back is something I've always really loved, and hopefully we'll see something similar in the future. What's really sad is that Apple no longer sells a phone with this form factor, which is something a lot of people want. A 4-inch screen might seem small, but for some people, that's the optimal size. We can dream of an iPhone SE 2, but at the moment, there aren't any real indicators that'll ever actually happen. Could you imagine an iPhone SE body, but with the iPhone X's display? That would be an amazing device, and with a competitive price point, it would probably be one of the best-selling smartphones out there. But I don't think that's something Apple will want to introduce anytime soon, as it would directly compete with the XR, which I think is unfortunately the spiritual successor to the SE. Not that the XR is a bad phone. In fact, current reviews are saying that it's a great phone. It's just that the XR is really big, and so people who don't want big phones don't have a lot of options anymore. That said, at least the SE is currently supported and will be in the years to come. And so, in a sense, the iPhone 5 does actually live on, with its design being still used today by millions of people. The iPhone 5 was a great smartphone. It's aged extremely well, and it's one of my personal favorite devices. It feels like a different world when you use one with iOS 6. It is so different from what we see today, not just in looks, but with everything. It isn't necessarily better than iOS 12, I don't think anyone's trying to say that, but it's different, and it's just kind of nostalgic, and I don't know, I really appreciate what we used to have, and the work that Steve Jobs and his team put into this. Unfortunately, iPhone 5s are very hard to find on iOS 6 anymore, but you can jailbreak your iPhone 5, any iPhone 5, and dual boot with Cool Booter if you know what you're doing. This specific phone is actually on iOS 6.0.1, which is crazy. It is also in practically brand new condition, and I got it all last year for $75, which was a steal. It just needs a new battery as it tends to die within a couple hours, so I'll have to look into that. But I think with that, I'm pretty much done. There wasn't a lot to say, I just wanted to briefly talk about the iPhone 5 as I saw on Mac Rumors that it was officially obsolete now, and I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, if it's kind of sad. I kind of want to hear what you guys have to say. Are any of you still using an iPhone 5? Let me know in the comments down below, I'm quite curious. Also, if you want to see more videos on iOS 6, fix, make sure you let me know by hitting that like button and subscribing, as I'm hopefully gonna do one on how it holds up all these years later relatively soon. Thank you so much for watching. You can follow me over on Twitter and Instagram if you'd like to keep up, links below. And with that all being said, I'm Josh from 91 Tech, and I will see you all next time.